time for the bell. How many options will you sell? Fire up your platform, get ready to enter. But first, let's get the mindset centered. Hey, hey, let's go. We're not here to gamble, we're here to trade. We follow the plan, that's how we get paid. Test and trade and have success. Find what works for you and forget the rest. Stats and probabilities is what we're about. Time to dismiss greed and doubt. Focus on the process, not the money. And the profits will flow like honey. Power Hour Live, let's start the show. Come on, trade hackers, get ready to go. 0 day options, time to make bank. Get locked and loaded, then be ready to plank. Hey.
Hey everyone, welcome to Power Hour Live, February 27th.
S&P almost exactly where we started the day. Just slightly higher. NASDAQ slightly green. Russell up 1%. Dow down about 0.5%. Gold and silver pretty flat. Notes and bonds a little bit red. 10-year yield up 0.5%. Oil up 1.5%. Natty gas up almost 4%. Soybeans down a little bit. Wheat and corn up. Euro and the pound flat. Bitcoin up another 5%. 58,000. VIX at 13.54. I've got a good little day going on here so far. Here's my one DTE. It's currently at about 36%. My profit target's at 45%. I've got my re-entries, which I haven't done any re-entries because my original ones from this morning are still on. They're getting ready to hit 90%. And then I've got, what else do I have here? I've got my quiet midday tranches. One hit 40%, another one hit 40%, another one hit 40%. My NDX looks like it's going to settle for max profit. I've got two other quiet midday tranches on. They're slightly red, so they need a little bit of a down move. And then my Wooga got filled at 410. That's on the 70-75s. So that is my zero DTE. Oh, I did have the one discretionary RIC I did take a loss on. I was looking, if it got down to the expected move, I would have taken it off and got a little profit, but it literally missed it by a couple points and then bounced, so I just cut it. For a small loss.
That is a nice day, Steve.
Good day for the good kids.
Okay, so I did my first Wooga here.
On the Wooga train.
Yeah, so 50%. So I got filled at 420, so 210.
Yep.
So I would be closing the whole thing, all four, like both calls, both puts, or just?
Yeah, the whole iron condor.
Okay, that's what I thought. At 210. Okay, perfect.
Thiago, expected move. So if you go to the option chain, I'm not sure what broker you use, but in TOS, it's this number right here. So you've got the percentage, which is the implied volatility of that option cycle. And then right next to it in parentheses, that plus or minus number, that's the expected move for the day. Okay, so I'm not sure if IB has that on the option chain or not. I'm sure they have it somewhere.
Do you close the whole thing at 50% or just part of it?
Yeah, the whole thing.
Okay.
Morrow, nothing to show the expected move of the option chains. You pretty happy about that? Let's see. Option strat maybe would have it. I'm trying to think here. I'd have to look around on that option strat to see if it's on there. Here's my NDX trade, right smack dab in the middle. Yeah, good point, Mauro. I mean, that's the quick back of the envelope kind of way. Just take the price of the at the money straddle. The expected move for the day is right around there. Yeah, Dick, hey, I don't know, man. I Option Omega doesn't have NDX, but just doing the same concept with SPX, it just did not test well, but I don't quite understand why. It just seems like from a mathematical probability standpoint, it should have a positive expectancy.
So for me, I have my AM iron condor number one, booked 20%, then stopped. So minus 220. Lunchtime number one, which same thing, 20%, then stopped. Sold some longs, ended up being plus $50. And I'm out of 20% of lunchtime number two, which was about 10 minutes before my power hour time. So, and the Wooga.
Yeah, no power hour for me today. Today's just in the, you know, pretty much where we started. Premiums are super low, so I'm not going to do a normal power hour besides the Wooga. So Dick K or anybody, going back to that NDX trade. So here I put the price slices where the expected move was at the beginning of the day for NDX. So you can see that the iron con, I mean, it covers, call it 90% of the expected move, right? Yes, right. 60, one standard deviation move is like 68%, call it whatever. I mean, you could call it six. Let's say this should hit 66% of the time, right? So, I mean, if you do the math, so let's just take it. Okay, so my max profit's 950, max loss is 1050. So let's say I do 100 trades and 66% of the time it hits 950. I know this is not exact, but 950 times 66 equals, so that'd be 62,700. 34 times out of the 100, it loses 1,050. So 1,050 times 34 equals minus 35,700, right? So 62,700 positive, 35,700 negative. So over, you know, large number of occurrences, seems like it would play out. Now, there is the in-between, right? So it may not be a max win or a max loss. There's going to be times where it expires in between. But it's only, you know, an NDX, it's only 10 wide, so very little chance it's going to expire right in between there, but some will. So just like I said, from a probabilistic number of occurrences over time, it should have a positive expectancy. I can't figure out why backtesting, I can't find anything that really gives any kind of value. SPX getting close to highs of day. Yeah, and I'm just doing it small. I mean, I'm doing two contracts on NDX. No stop. You know, so there are also times it'll go way out of range and then come back and settle in. So you don't have to worry about getting stopped out. Here's my Wooga. So, Dick K, I've got two of the quiet tranches left. They need to move down, otherwise they could get themselves in a little trouble here, which would wipe out the four winners. Three winners. My 1-2 double calendar from earlier today is already up 7%. Might take off some of that if I get to 10% by the end of the day. My 6-7 from Friday is up about 5%. My 5-7 from Friday is up about 3. My 3-4 from Monday is down about 2%.
Well, I hope I'm not bad luck for the Wooga, because I remembered the only one I've ever taken was that time that moved to the downside, like way out of range, almost.
The one time that we took max loss on it?
Yeah, that's the only time I've traded it. This is my second
Basically,
time.
The one time in 12 months that it took a max loss is the time you traded it?
Yep. And now mine is, now it's pushing up, so it's, I hope I'm not bad luck.
The Dr. Chad curse.
I mean, mine's already way off center.
Yeah, I'm going to need a little down move for basically everything I got on now.
God forbid we have two. This SPX has two red days in a row.
It's not allowed. Well, we had two red days. This would be
Did
three.
We? A lot. Going back to last Friday.
Yeah, Friday. Well, it closed lower than when it opened. I'm not sure if it closed lower than the previous day's close. Let's see. 50, 87, 50. No, didn't. Yeah. So, yeah, technically, this would be two in a row if we closed red. So on my two re-entries here, my 1-to-1 is trading at $1.25 and my 90% profit target's at 95 cents. The other one's trading at 260 and that one's at $1.90. So just a little lower and those should just close out.
Wooga's in the trade plans, but it's also, if you scroll up to the end of yesterday, I know somebody posted a screenshot of it. I'll see if I can find it real quick.
Here you go, fast 5731. Oh, looks like you got it. There's the back test. I don't have it on my trade plan sheet just because I just kind of do it just more on a discretionary basis, but yeah, MRP, NDX, it'll get wide, so that's one reason I don't use stops or anything on that, and I'm okay using NDX for this specific trade because it let's see. My order's at 25 cents to close, and it's shown as trading at 30 cents, so maybe not quite there yet, but sometimes it won't even hit. Took half off of my VXX vertical for about 50% of max. Give my rut duck another day. If it stays here, pushes higher, I'll close it out for beak profit. Corn finally got a little bounce.
Here's a question for you. So if the Wooga is sitting pretty centered and you hit your 50%, you don't scale out at all, huh?
No, I mean, it's purely back test based. And so those parameters are test the best.
Yeah, that's just what you do.
That's just what the Wooga does.
Okay, so exit by 352, huh? If you haven't hit 50%. Where is
nice
Wooga?
Day trading futures too. Best day in a while. Oil 3040, ES a little over 1500, and Dow 505. So I can't complain, but I also missed a big trade in wheat. I was trying to get long wheat, and I put the order in pre-market, and I forgot it's not open yet. You can't trade it yet. You got to wait till 8:30. Central, and then I was planning on it. I had it written on a note to right in front of me to enter at the open. So I missed that big up move in wheat. That probably would have been another, based on the size I would have done, probably, I don't know, probably somewhere between 1,000 and 2,000. So good day trading, really good day trading all around. Got to trade that weed, Naughty Dog. I did work. I worked on my the futures day trading price action course a little bit last night. Getting close. By the way, we're doing a live trade steward session 30 minutes after the close today. I posted in the trade steward channel for anyone interested. I'm basically just going to take a option omega back test and build a bot from scratch just to kind of show you how I do it. Kind of point out some of the little things, and then from there we'll just kind of open it up to questions or comments or anything. Getting closer to my 90%. I still need a little down move. Yeah, Mukesh, for sure. It'll be recorded. Yeah, Dick K, I think I feel like I need to cut one of my quiet tranches loose. This thing continues to rip. It's not gonna feel good. I have my NDX in my bot set at 95%. So it's sitting at a 25-cent limit right now, but sometimes that'll fill and sometimes it'll just expire without even filling. We get ES90, we could roll over or roll higher. Okay. I also had some puts loaded up. I had an order of 20 short puts loaded that were priced to get filled if price got down to the expected move. And I was about 30 cents away from those getting filled before it ripped. So I ended up just canceling that. And that's when I ended up just buying some futures for this up move. So I had a really good day and I missed out on some really nice winners too.
Out pushing highs.
Yep, right at highs of day, which is the first 5 minute candle.
Yeah. So maybe it'll get rejected. Wouldn't take much of a down move and get me out of 40% of my last TLC trade I got on.
No, just a little pullback.
My order's at 345 and price is currently at 387. So
my one DTE. Currently at about 35%. I need 45% for that one to take off. right around time for tranche two, which I'm not doing, but it'd be a 75 straddle for low premiums.
There we go.
Here we
go. 40% out of 40%. Very nice.
Closed out my, closed out both my trades from this morning, my two re-entries in my challenge portfolio. So now if my 1DTE can hit 45%, that would be a good little bump in my challenge portfolio. So my 1-to-1 booked about 3,900. My 3-to-2 booked almost 2,500, and then my 1DTE is currently up 1,700. Not sure if that's going to get to 45% or not. So for my challenge portfolio, up about a little over 8,000 so far.
All right, 260 is my next 60%.
Check out my Steve, trade plan, Naughty Dog.
Steve's got so many portfolios.
I need a couple other accounts, to be honest. It's too crowded sometimes. I'm not going 10K to a million. It's more like it's more like 150K to 152 million. That's what I'm going for. Yeah. I mean, I'm not greedy. All right, let's see what Wooga's doing.
Sitting pretty good.
Oh, I forgot I had another one on. I've got a. I forgot I put this call it a Chad-like trade on because I felt like I needed some more on. I got out of half at 20%. In fact, I forgot to reduce the stop now that I'm thinking about it.
You never forget, like, you have a trade on that needs to be closed by the end of the day and then realize it's on the next day, do you?
I've done that before. It's at 5:30. In fact, I just did that. I think it was last month. I had a diagonal on, which is part of a different, it was kind of a part of a time fly in NDX. And on Friday at expiration, I forgot to close it. So I was left with just the longs on Monday. And luckily the market went up, so it ended up being a $26,000 winner.
No way.
That's awesome. Love those accidents. But could have been really bad if the market had tanked over the weekend.
Right.
That's right, madam. I mean, I make enough mistakes that go against me. I think I'm, you know, I'm entitled to when it goes in my favor every once in a while. My 40% is at 395. It's currently trading at $5. So need a little more down move.
$0.30 more down? No. $0.50 down, I'll hit 60%.
We could hit 35%. Two and a half percent a day is awesome.
Yeah, for sure, madam.
My midday tranches, these two I have left, they definitely need a down move. Not real optimistic about the downside here. I may just cut those loose.
No, I just don't want it to push highs. It can just stay where it's at.
I'm going to cut one of them loose. So my 1-2 DTE double calendar, let's see, what did I get into that for? 890.
Don't like this price action. Oh, that really pushing.
That's right. Turn around. Nothing to see up here.
Nope. Yo, naughty dog, just booking profits.
Wooga could go to 5,100 as long as it comes back before the close.
I just soon hit 50% before it does that.
Better on the heart.
Yeah. And I've had too many in February, too many power hours where I've seen a little green bar just ripping upward.
See what's going on in stock land today. Jumia, the Amazon of Africa, has been on fire. Almost a double in the last month.
There she goes.
New highs of day.
Knew it.
Zoom up 7% after earnings.
Green bars, man.
What did I get stopped out of here? That must have been my...
I surely would hate to be 0 for 2 in the Woogas.
That's funny, Dick K.
How old's your son?
Yeah, so I have accounts for both my boys, and so I let them pick their own stocks. And they so of course they pick all the things they like. You know, they got Google because they like YouTube, they got Apple because they like their iPads. I just let them do whatever they want. And they've never really shown, like, they think trading is so boring. They don't, never really show much interest. But then one day my oldest gets in the car and he's like, "Dad, I think I want to be a trader when I get older." I was like, "Oh, really? What? Like, what changed? What's going on?" He's like, "Well," and they'd had the account. They got it. We started the account like right at the bottom during COVID. And so of course, right out of the gate, their accounts took off. He's like, "Well," I was like, "What changed?" He's like, "Well," he's like, I'm really good at it." And I was like, "Oh, okay. I didn't say anything. I just encouraged him." He's already lost interest again, but he thought he had it all figured out.
All right, let's get some pullback here.
$126 million to the buy side, early indication.
Let's get a good, healthy pullback.
Yeah, they got into Meta at a really good price too. That's their biggest winner. Here's one of them. They have Apple. He likes when we stay in Airbnbs, so he's got Airbnb. He's got C3 AI. He's got AMC because he likes to watch movies. He actually caught that one. He What's caught AMC that one at? Right before the whole GameStop AMC. We wrote it up. We sold some of it, but still have some. Now it's at $4.70. He's got Amazon, Coinbase, Google, Robinhood, Bitcoin, the Bitcoin ETF. We just bought that one. Meta, Netflix, Nintendo. I bought some of those Yield Max, NVIDIA, and ARK. He's got Roblox because he likes to play Roblox. Snapchat, Tesla, and Yum Brands because he likes Pizza Hut. The other one's got Apple, Airbnb, AI, Coinbase. He likes to play fantasy on DraftKings, so he's got DraftKings. Google, Robinhood, Bitcoin, Meta, Netflix, Nike, Roblox, Starbucks, Tesla, Uber.
Getting close to 20-50%.
Wooga's that I've got Wooga 42%.
Yeah, I'm at 210 is my exit.
My one DTE still sitting around 37%. Did it hit it? Did it hit the rollover point, Dick K? Would you say 90? Almost. 88.5.
Keep coming.
Cody, I actually made them employees of one of my entities, and so I pay them, and then that money that they earned, they contributed to a Roth. So, and I added a little bit, but. That's how I did it.
$0.10 away from getting out at 60%. Of my TLC and be done there.
Wooga's trading at 235. I need 205 to close that one at 50%.
Yep, I need 210. Build on 60% and out of my lunchtime number two. The green day. First time in a while I haven't done any power hour trades. Did the Wooga instead.
Yeah, my NDX still hasn't filled at 25%, 25 cents.
Yeah, it's kind of what I was thinking too, Dick K.
Filled on a 5 of 9 of my 1-2s for 10% from the one I just put on this morning. I'll leave the other ones on until tomorrow morning.
Come on, Theta. Have you ever not been able to close the Wooga? You ever have a problem with it?
What's that?
Have you ever had a problem trying to close, since you're closing a full iron condor?
If it gets way out of bounds, then you just got to watch the longs. If they don't have a bid, you know, they're down to 5 cents right now, 5 and 10 cents.
Right.
Then you may, then you'd have to switch over just to the shorts.
Gotcha.
$126 million to the buy side still.
I'm all. Need about 7 cents.
Yeah, Ugo's getting close.
Was getting close. Come on.
I'm going to go ahead and close out my last re-entry here. And I think I'm going to close out my last quiet tranche also. Just not feeling a down move into the close.
No. Need a nickel. And the Wooga's closed. All right.
My Wooga's almost there.
I got filled at 210.
Looking for 205, didn't hit it.
Get back down here. Vic's trying to spike up.
A little over 15 minutes to go.
Ugh, I knew this was going to happen.
I thought you got hit on the Wooga, or you got
I did
something else.
No, but I know you guys are wanting it to pull back. I was really hoping it would hit for you guys. Still might.
I like the team player out of you, Chad.
Yeah, no, I'm out of everything.
Still 126 million to the buy side. Final MOC in 5 minutes.
Dow came down a little bit after trying to push up there. Dow coming down now. a little over 4K for me with the Wooga and TLC trades.
How many contracts did you do on the Wooga?
I did 10.
10?
Yep.
Oh, you went in guns a-blazing on the Wooga for the, I guess, second time.
Get a little pullback here. Dow's coming down. Let's get a little pullback for everyone. Doesn't look like it wants to come down. Russell pushing.
Yeah, I was knocking on my 205 order, just didn't quite push through.
Yeah, I had a 210, so you had to be close. Nickel.
Dick K had 210 and didn't get filled.
Really? Keep coming, little buddy. Yeah, it definitely is a game of inches, that's for sure. Is this normal? Like the game of inches, is that pretty normal for it or no?
This depends on the day, I guess.
Yeah. Look at the Dow come
whether
down.
It's centered or not.
Right. Oh, it flipped. Thought it was coming.
Market on close number here in about 20 seconds. $1.4 billion to the buy side. My Wooga's back to even.
Yeah, it's kind of crazy just how it gets over there testing one side. It can be a game of inches. Keep coming down, buddy.
back up to 30, 40%. Just like that.
Just like that.
So it'll close out here in a few seconds. 352. All right,
get back
scratched out a little profit on the Wooga. Seven minutes to go. Make sure I don't have anything else on here. I still got my NDX has not filled at 25 cents.
VIX really spiking.
Oh, I got still got my one DTE on that'll close here shortly. It's at 35%. So it doesn't look like it'll hit its 45, but it'll get closed for a profit here in 2 minutes. I'm going to go ahead and close it actually.
Yeah, VIX really coming up.
All right, closed my one DTE for about 35%. Nice rookie trader.
Nice job.
Meech up 6.3% today. Or on the Wooga. SPX heading up to 50.79. 5 minutes to go. Lasso's up 4.4% today. Nice.
Nice job.
Thanks, Fish. I'll check that out. I'll make a note.
Pretty good results today.
Yeah, because of the way that Trade Steward had the VIX versus, how we manually look at it or how Toss looks at it. None of those fired for me. So I had to manually fire my one DTE and my re-entry. So good thing I did that because it ended up being a good profit. 3.5 minutes to go. I feel like the S&P is going to make one more push.
Yeah, so there I'll show she you goes.
I'll show you guys something I've been doing here. A little end of day strategy I've been doing. So I've been end of day, I've been selling a butterfly if I can right at the money five wide, if I can get $2 or better. So I got filled at 205 today, and then I'm immediately putting in an order for vertical spreads on either side. And so like what I did today is I sold the 50.75 put butterfly, and then when it pushed up, I just got filled at $1 on the vertical. So I've locked in a profit of 1,050. And then if price comes back down below 50.75 before the close, I could book even more here. So really, if basically the idea is if you can get in the last 10 to 15 minutes after you enter your short fly, if you can get a move of $5, you know, one strike, most likely you're going to get filled on that vertical, lock in a profit, and then you have a kind of a lotto to the other side. So if the market were to drop here, if it were to drop to 70, I'd make a little over 6,000, which obviously not very likely, but I have a little over $1,000 profit locked in. Seconds to go. Looks like fit around 50.80. Yeah, Suresh, I plan to just do a little demo of Trade Steward and basically take a option Omega back test and just kind of start from scratch and build a bot and then just kind of go through some of the details around it. There is the bell, 50.78.23. I'll be talking more about this. I've been trading it every day for about the last several weeks, trying to kind of iron out how I want to do it, but I'll talk more about it. All right, all. Let's see. Tomorrow's live stream. Tomorrow is the 28th. Wednesday, Chad will be streaming live in the morning for the Mighty 90 and Runners, and then we'll be back for Power Hour. And then if you want to join the Trade Steward session here in about 30 minutes, the link is in the Trade Steward channel. All right, all. Take care. Have a good night.